In this vlog, we would like to continue with our tutorial on Flutter Drift Database. So in our previous tutorial, we have seen the basic introduction to the Drift Database, and also there we have tried to create a table and try to insert the data and fetch the data as well. So if you have not gone through that particular tutorial, I suggest you to go through that particular tutorial before getting started with this tutorial, because we are just continuing the same tutorial here. And we are going to add an additional concept to our database, which is joins here. So we are going to fetch the data from both the tables and try to print it on our console. I was getting few comments regarding this particular topic to be done with the Drift database. So I'm adding this particular tutorial. So now let's try to see the basic overview of joins here and what are we going to do in this particular tutorial. It might sound a new topic for few of you, and few of you are already aware of this particular topic, joins in database, but as we are covering this particular tutorial for the beginners, I want to add a few intro points regarding the joins here. So now let's try to see what we are trying to perform in this particular tutorial. We are going to have two tables here. The names of the tables will be like products and details here. And with the help of a joins, we are going to compare two rows here and try to fetch the information from both the rows, from both the tables, with the help of these particular rows here. So it might sound a little bit confusing for you, but stay tuned till the end of this tutorial and you will get a very good clarity on what are joins and how do we implement in Drift database. So this is our first table, that is products here, and inside this particular products we are going to have three columns like ID, title and description. So these are the three columns we are going to have in our first table, that is products. And let us consider our second table, which is details here, and the details table will have ID again, and we have name here, and also we have a product ID here. So what is a product ID again? We have separately a products table, right? And what is this product ID again in our details table here? So product ID is nothing but the same ID which we are going to specify in our products table here. So that particular ID we are storing in our details table as well to establish a relation how we will get this particular product ID. Now whenever we try to insert a data into our products table, then we are going to fetch the ID and store the ID when we are trying to insert data into our details table. And one point to be noted here, in both products table and details table, ID is auto incremented value. So we are not going to specify any ID value manually. And also you can do it by just removing the auto increment field. That's all. So now let's get started with this particular tutorial and try to see in deep level implementation of the Drift database and also joins concept. So here let's get back to our Android Studio, and in our previous tutorial we have seen what are all the requirements, that is dependencies, to be added into our pubspec file. So I suggest you to refer that tutorial, and we'll be directly getting onto our project here. So we'll be directly going into the data.dot file, and we are going to add the other table which we have discussed just now, that is details table. So in our previous tutorial we have added the products table, and now let's try to add the details table. So class details extends table here. So to create a table, we need to extend a class. We need to extend our class with table here so that we make use of those properties. And now let's try to create a column. So int column get ID. So just like our products table, we have an ID in our details table as well. In the same way, let us specify integer dot auto increment. So just now I've said, right, you can just remove the auto increment if you don't want the ID. to be auto incremented and you want to pass it manually, so you can just remove auto increment here and you can just manually provide your ID. And the second column here we are going to have is a text column, and for which we are going to consider it to be name here, okay, and this is of the type text. And now interestingly, the third column is what we are making to use in our joins, to perform joins. I think you might have already guessed it correctly. So yes, we are going to consider an int column here because our product ID is also of type int. So we need to have an int column, and then how we need to refer to our previous table and try to fetch the ID here. So let us specify the name here, product ID integer dot references, and here it is clearly showing us two values to be provided, that is table and column. So what is our previous table name? Products, right? So let us specify it. And what is the column which we want to save here? Specify it by providing hash before the column name here. And that's it. We are good to go. Our details table is now ready, but we need to add few more things here so as to fetch the data from our details table. If you have observed here in our previous tutorial, we have only specified products. Let us specify details also here. We are trying to fetch products.title now. And additionally, I also want to fetch details.name. And again, this is just an example here. In the real-time implementation, you can fetch the fields which you require. So just try to observe this particular example and try to implement it in your own way. And if you are getting any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. I will surely try to help you. And now we are trying, previously we are trying to fetch the products.title from products here. But now we also require details.name, right? So we need to join these two tables, and it's that simple. We need to just make use of dot join here, and we need to specify the other table from where we wanted to fetch this particular name here. And there are again two types of joins here, inner join and outer join. And for now we are going to use inner join, and we'll be also discussing about outer join in another tutorial. And here details, which is nothing but our table's name here, and here we need to compare it. So details dot product ID here, details dot product ID dot equals expression, and here we need to specify our products dot ID. So we need to compare our details dot product ID with our products table. So inside our products table also we have an ID. Details table we have product ID, right? We need to compare this one with our ID in our products table. So these two will match, and then we are going to fetch the details of that particular rows. Okay, and coming down here, let's try to add our details table as well. And now the most important thing is, like, we need to generate data.g.dart file. And if you observe here, we are already having this particular file, but this is of our previous tutorial, and now we have added an extra table and we have added few extra configurations to fetch the data. So this particular file is no use now. So we need to delete this and need to go to the terminal here, and inside the terminal we need to build this particular file. So this is the command, like flutter pub run build underscore runner and build here. So this will generate us the data.g.dart file which we have specified now. Okay, so let's try to run this, and here you can see our file will be generated successfully within few seconds. So it's also specifying us the time, like 5.9 seconds. And try to just close the folder and open it, and here you can see our data.g.dart file is generated. And with the help of this file only, we can make use of our database, like storing the data, fetching the data, and all these things are performed with the help of this particular data.g.dart file. Okay, so you can just go through it. Here you will find the methods to insert the data, select the data, and all these kinds of things you will be finding over here. Okay, so now get back here. And we have added a variable here, you can see. We have added a variable ID here, but we are not using it. And now let's try to use it. So await db dot, we are trying to insert. So into, we need to select our table here. So db dot details and insert some information here. Details companion dot insert. And here we can see the fields are auto populated here, like name and product ID. So name, we need to specify, like some name we need to specify. I'm just specifying database name, that's all. And here for product ID, we need to specify this particular variable now. What is there in this variable? Let's try to see it. Add a semicolon. And let's try to see, whenever you are going to insert a details into your first table, that is products, you are going to fetch the ID here. And in our initial part of this tutorial, I have explained you with the help of a diagram, right? We are going to store. So here I have explained you, right? We are going to store the ID in our second table, that is details, like product ID we are storing. Just compare it like this. So yes, this is, we are going to implement here in programmatical way here. We are going to implement it here. We are going to store it. And now let's try to print the information. So we are going to print the data which we are going to insert into the products table, and also now we are going to print the data we are going to insert into our details table. So let's try to run this, and now let's try to run this particular code. We are making use of an emulator here, but there is nothing to see in our application. So it will be like a white page coming up. So here you can just have a look here. There is nothing to see as an output in our emulator. I just want to print the data into our console to make it as simple as possible for you to understand the concept, rather than concentrating on application UI interfaces and all those things. So here you can see we have inserted data into our products table, and we have inserted data into our details table. And where is join here? So let's try to implement it as well. So let's try to fetch the joins data as well. We need to add an expression of type string here. So expression of type string, and here get, let's specify like data. And what do we require? We require products dot title here, plus specify constant, and here value. So why we are specifying this, I will explain you. I will explain you this in, and here specify. So why we are specifying in this particular format, I will explain you with the help of output. Plus, we also require some data from details table. So this is where we are actually making use of the joins here. Concept of joins here. Details dot name, and now close the bracket. So to open the bracket and close the bracket, we are adding these constants, and close the bracket here, and that's it. Again, what we need to do now to fetch the information from this particular expression. Yes, you have guessed it right. We need to delete this data.g.dart file, and again move back to our terminal. And when you tap on the up arrow here, you will be getting the recent commands which you have run in your terminal. So let's try to rerun this particular command and try to regenerate our file. And this time it took 6 seconds now. Okay, so it's not a constant time period. It will vary upon your system. So here data.g.dart file. And now let's get back to our main.dart file here. And now I will make use of this particular products view and try to fetch the data. So let's add the same line again here, and instead of details here, I will be making use of products view. And what is products view here? You can see, so this is our products view. And now let's try to run this particular code and observe the output once. So here you can see our products view data is now printed here. Carefully observe. First, we are trying to print our products table and then our detail table and then the combination of the both information which we have stored in both the tables here. So title is coming from the products table and name is coming from the details table. I hope this is very clear for you, a clear understanding of the concept of joins and how to implement them in the Drift database in our Flutter application. So yes, this is it for this particular tutorial. If you are having any queries on this particular concept, do let me know in the comment section below. And the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. And again, I'm specifying, like, to understand this particular tutorial properly, you need to go through our previous tutorial on the Drift database. There we have covered all the basic concepts and we are just making use of the same code over here and try to add a new concept, that is joins here. So if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.